described in Captioned Media Program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Waiting, sir. This is the day of the month we fill our bellies with something besides turtle, old sport. The ships come in. Get yourself a grand and we'll have a party.
Say, satisfactory cargo this trip, Captain?
Ebony and spices.
What's news outside?
Wars and rumors.
No. Gossip. Tidbits of scandal. Something huge.
Red Butts at Macassar found a pearl worth a couple of thousand. And left his wife. That American widow at Titi is about to have...
Oh, that's not news.
Scallywag Englishman still here?
Yes.
How did he ever light on this particular fly speck on the map?
Escaping from something or other, I suppose.
He's a bit light in the head, if you ask me.
Aren't we all here? It's the heat, isn't it?
You're pretty easy on him, Mr. Crichton.
This is a lonely station, Captain. I suppose I'm jealous of the reckless way he squanders the priceless treasure of life.
What the devil is that?
See you next month, Lanier.
Why didn't you...
Too sinking heart.
What's going on out there? A celebration?
Oh, a ship comes in. Oh, you know them. They're like a lot of giddy kids. Oi.
Here it is, Ginger, on the dock. Edward C. Wilson, Esquire. You know, I'm blessed if when you get these B.A. do, I don't wonder if I oughtn't to rise and curse.
If you don't mind, I'll just pop out the back way.
Oh, but wait. I was going to cash that for you, Jim. Come here. Endorse the check. See? It's all ready for you. £8. That's 72 gulden exactly this time. Thank you. What's the idea? Orang, bully must.
Saya, Tuan Besar.
A shopkeeper's honor, please.
Sit down.
I got a date, Mr. Gray.
Sit down.
It's a dirty trick.
You are the only money, don't you? Tell them to present their chips of Mr. Wilson's indebtedness.
You, my friend, are you not? I'll never trust you again.
Here! How much?
63 gulden, Jun Bashar.
You can wait for the money outside in the clerk's office. Now be a reasonable man. Pay them. Get it off your chest and off mine.
And leave me with only a quid to my name? Why, you little tin god, let me tell you something.
Pay them.
Okay.
You're a lost sheep, if ever I saw one. Going to pieces under that cocky hat of yours like a rotten tub. If you ever had a backbone, he's all been dissolved in booze. Well, I'm sick and tired of your drunken uproars.
And I...
Oh. Here, you come up to my house tonight and have half a dozen bottles of beer.
I accept your apology.
I beg your pardon.
It's all right. See you tonight for the beer. Hey, I suppose we'll be having company.
Oh, you do. Yeah. Here, that way. Cure impossible.
Yeah, and you, my dear sir, tossing me to those thieves are a traitor to our race.
Here we come gathering, not in May, not in May, not in May. Here we come.
Mina, catch him. Pay attention. Start again. One, two.
Here we come gathering, not in May, not in May.
Lear, this is no place for that. Cato, you finish it alone and set them an example.
Here we come gathering, not in May, on a cold and frosty morning.
There. Sit down. Now, children, it's good, but not good enough. Once more from the beginning. One, two.
Here we come gathering, not in May, not in May, not in May. Here we come gathering.
Serena, you're not paying attention. Stand up and let me hear you say the word gathering. Gathering.
Gathering.
No. Gathering.
Gaz. No, Niam, you Jones. Bang yak susa. Too difficult.
Difficult. Not deep. The word is difficult. Nothing worth having is easy. Of course it's difficult. Sit down. If at first you don't succeed, try again. Now we'll sing the song, paying particular attention to the vowels. We'll start with the second verse. Ready? One, two. Serena, Titi, and Isa for nuts in May. Ready? One, two.
We will have Serena, Titi, and Isa for nuts in May, nuts in May, nuts in May. We will have Serena, Titi, and Isa for nuts in May on a cold and frosty morning.
Yes? I suppose it is difficult for you, but for me too sometimes, you know. Exercise books. We'll now take down the following lines written by Stevenson, who was a very great poet and a very good man, although he was born in Scotland. There's so much bad in the best of us, and so much good in the worst of us, that it little behoves any of us to talk about the rest of us.
Ooh, Lonnie Jones!
出去！不要！你昨天没有给钱，你今天你又来了啊！你给了钱你再走，别动！你给了钱再走。
啊！啊！
realize what a good deed you have done, first we must find the police and put an end to this wickedness.
Barmaid's eyes are blue, not black at home in England. The way his colder cheeks are red as apples. You can fill your lungs with clean, bright cold in England. You paint pictures with your frozen breath. Let your boots make music in the snow. In winter time. At home. In England.
It's pretty. Even if I cannot understand it.
Took that child under my wing.
Can't you corked up hens stop scratching at other people's business?
Oh, you can't give up what you're doing. You don't know.
Where was her father? She didn't say anything about that dim set in there. Madam, would you kindly remove your little tea kettle to another stove?
I give this man a chance. Arrest him!
Where's my beautiful hat?
Oh, that's what it.
Where's my beautiful hat? Where's my beautiful hat? Oh, there it is.
Fellow men, spiritually, as well as surgically, but you have tried my patience beyond endurance.
You should be on your knees.
Asleep! You ought to be on your feet. Grant me patience. These people have no sense of moral responsibility or dignity.
If it wasn't for you, Dudley, I think I'd give up.
Has the sergeant told you?
Told me what?
I should have thought in the ordinary course of routine, sir, you'd have been acquainted with affairs in your own district.
I do not encourage my staff to drop in at my private house, except on matters of importance.
But this is far more than important. It concerns the very salvation of the whole community. I mean, hardly others has to do with that renegade they call Mr. Ted.
Eh?
Another of his revolting outbreaks.
Drunk again.
He wrecked a shop and half killed the proprietor.
Well, where is he?
In jail, of course. My sister and I.
Ah, you see.
Yes.
Yes?
We feel very strongly that something ought to be done.
Now do sit down, Mr.
No.
Jones.
Thank you. This man is a public scandal and it...
Forgive me. But have you and your sister, in addition to complain, ever offered him a helping hand?
Everyone let us come near him every time.
No one appreciates more than I do the good work that you and your sister are doing, Mr. Jones. But are you sure you exercise your calling with all possible tact?
The situation is beyond tact.
I shall naturally listen to the evidence against him and to his defense.
There can be no defense.
My dear sir, I administer justice according to the laws of my government.
But, Mr.
Adieu.
Mr. I beg your pardon, Mr. Greuther, for speaking.
Good evening.
他把我的铺子统统给我打坏了，我拿这个酒瓶，我前妻打他呀，我打错了，我打到寻不透上了，对不起呀，他又把我这个眼睛给我打坏了，他又把我这个胳膊给我打坏了，此刻我的老婆孩子也没有机会了，我也没有面孔了，我的小孩子也没有饭吃了，我的老婆也没有脸面了，我也没有面子了，知道的我的心也疼啊，我觉也不能睡，饭也不能吃，跟个死一样，偶尔发ginger。
I'll dry up your blubbering monkey.
你赶紧的给我钱吧，你。好啊，千万不要打。Sit down.
I'm in the cart all right, but I was blind. Look at the provocation I have. That old clothesline ties me up in knots every time she comes in the wind.
Monsieur Contrôleur, if I may intervene.
Owen, I can defend myself.
Ginger, Wilson, after all, you are the prisoner here and not the prosecutor. If you follow. Now, Miss Dog.
Miss Dog in the manger.
Wilson!
Well, how can a man keep still faced with her? I can't.
Evil communications corrupt good manners.
Natter. But there are other cases to be disposed of. Now proceed, if you please.
Oh, I have nothing against him personally. He can be as insolent to me as he chooses. That doesn't worry me. But he shall not be insolent.
Miss Jones.
Not only his slavery to drink, though that's a public scandal against which I, as a woman, as well as a worker here for spiritual betterment, have a right to protest. But yesterday I found him with one of my own pupils. Inciting her to be wicked. There's no one to stop him. I tell you, his example here utterly destroys our efforts. Mine and my brother's to...
Well, what, Miss Jones?
To help these people to find the truth. They're such children, Minerva. So easily influenced. How are we to guide them if this so-called white man mocks? At us. We are odd, I suppose. But by their fruits ye shall know them.
You sentimental suction pump.
Taking all the fun out of life.
That man is a peril to women.
You're a thorn in the flesh of man. Wills!
He's still drunk.
No! It's not drink you're afraid of. It's a bit of normal virility in a man.
Mr. Greuther. I am not on trial here.
Miss Jo, understanding is a great thing, isn't it? Everybody. In the Calvestraat in Amsterdam, Piccadilly in London, in those leafy avenues in Paris, on that little street that scared me, I forget the name, in New York, everybody is flotsam and jetsam, not knowing why they're here or where they're going, but behaving as they do. And very oddly, too, sometimes. Because they're human. I'm afraid I've bored you. Is my English education.
Regarding Edward C. Wilson, Miss Jones, what do you suggest?
Oh, I do try to look on the brighter side of things. And I suppose there must be some good in a man who's kind to his dog and keeps his moustache tidy. But he must be taught a lesson.
You have something in your mind?
Deportation. I'm sorry, but it's necessary.
Yep. Thank you, Miss Jones.
Thank you, Minerva.
She's right, you know. Deport me. Haven't you been idle, incorrigible, drunk, and immoral here?
I'll pay for the Chinaman's stuff I broke if he'll give me time.
You'll pay for the damage, all right. But it's me who'll give you the time. And that will be 1 month in jail. Great here. Merk het bonus.
I have to end bazaar.
It's only a month? I protest! It's ridiculous!
If you'll excuse me, you Frau.
Lest he be deported.
My sentence stands.
Send him away so that we can cultivate our garden in peace. No!
Going down. There, you're already naughty little girl.
You see?
I see, all right. Enter this sentence. 3 months.
Me?
Hard labor.
What do you say?
On the road gang.
Ho!
Sent you and Wilson here.
I had you and Bazaar.
You can't leave things like this.
You have your obligations. Obligations to us, too.
But we work hard, Mr. Groyter.
Awfully hard. You must know that.
Cry.
Oh, I must talk to you. I'm a little emotional, I'm afraid.
Indeed.
Wilson in the road gang. Have you considered what the social effect on the natives will be? It will undermine our authority. You must see that it's best to deport him. Pluck him out. Like an offending eye.
Heaven knows. Pardon me. I've promised myself I'd deport him often enough.
I knew you'd see the light.
I've just sent for Mr. Wilson.
Come on. I can't bear to be near that man.
But, Martha, I...
Sergeant, you may go. Come here, Wilson. Come here. So, you were going to kill me, eh?
Not swallowing my words precisely, I was mad for a minute. I got over it.
That's very kind of
you. Does stick in my craw, you giving way to that twitty twerp. Mm-hmm. That hangover's beating its wings in my head. I'm going to sit down.
If my head wasn't so vacant, there wouldn't be any room for the wings to beat. Oh, thank you.
Do you know what I am, Mr. Controller?
Yes, crazy.
Beer?
Never mind if it's...
Down the hatch.
She got?
Thanks. You know, I don't know what to do with you. Neither did anybody at home. I was a problem child. I'm half in mind to deport you.
I'm glad to have met you, Controller. When do I start?
Oh, I didn't suggest it. They did.
Do you mean you don't want to kick me out?
Well, I'm lonely enough as it is. No.
Can't you control yourself? I've made practically a companion of you. Your behaving like this, it hurts. I'll do that time on the road gang.
No, no.
It's your duty to punish me.
A white man on the road gang.
Oh, I never thought of that. Couldn't you just put me in jail here and have my government hem and haw at me for feeding an Englishman for 3 months?
Here it is.
Think, man. Think.
I'm trying to.
So am I. Mr. Grider, do think of something. I ought to get back to jail.
I've got.
It's a blessing.
I shall send you to Ego Island.
There's no punishment.
He will. There is no alcohol on Ego.
Father, I'll believe that, please. I'm going to sign the pledge tomorrow anyway.
Stop yawning.
Oh, how hopeless I am.
This morning, I sentenced you, Edward C. Wilson. Here, what does that C stand for, Ed?
Lord.
That's been bothering me for months. I sentenced you, Edward Claude Wilson, to 3 months hard labor. It will be worked out on Ego Island.
Tom's address, Ton Bazaar.
Selfish swine, that fellow, charging off to Ego like that. Beer has to have company to be enjoyed. Dress, what for?
on this night of Manton Bazaar, officer with Mr. and Mrs. Jones.
Home it.
Now, Mr. Jones isn't well either today. And you wouldn't want me to leave him all alone, would you?
Bye, Nanya.
Remember, that's a compound fracture. She must be kept absolutely quiet.
Sire, Nanya.
But no one here, Makasi. Nanya, John, in the hospital. Toon was up, and Toon, John, on the bed.
Oh, then say I wouldn't dream of disturbing. Oh, say. Miss Jones, I was just saying how disappointed.
How nice of you not to forget our small festivities.
But how could I?
But do you mind not smoking? It makes my brother feel sick at the best of times. Oliver, throw it away. And you must keep the stones at Mr. Jones's feet quite hot, you know.
Oh, it's nothing serious with your brother, I trust.
Just a touch of malaria again.
Oh, then I wouldn't dream of inconvenience.
Oh, it isn't at all inconvenient.
Martha.
It's Mr. Grotter, dear.
Oh, well, I'll leave the door ajar, dear, then I can chaperone you.
Yes, dear.
Now, wouldn't it be better if I came to dinner another night?
Oh, I never heard of such a thing. Now, do sit down. I've got a real English dinner for you tonight. A boiled fish, a risotto, and tapioca pudding.
Tapioca? Oh, fancy. It's my favorite pudding. What is it, Sergeant?
The jongens was pas om appetit gekomen, meneer. And said that the kapala al daar, zeer in zijn beek heeft, daar, zeer ziek. He heeft a doctor nodig.
What is it?
The chief on Mabutiti has a little appendix, that's all.
Appendicitis? But it must be operated on at once.
But appendicitis or not, since your brother is unable to go to him, I'm afraid his appendix will have to wait.
But I shall go myself.
Oh, yes, I know you're qualified, but you can't remove an appendix, can you?
Oh, I've helped her into it scores of times. But an acute appendix is nothing to dawdle over. The poor soul might die.
But Mabutiti is 80 kilometers away and...
What? My brother will give me his blessing, I'm sure.
Oh, Adoma, I'm thankful that woman's not sister to me. Sergeant.
Ja, meneer.
You will escort Nanya Jones in the government lodge.
Ja, meneer.
Get out that notebook of yours and put this order down. On your return, you will pass Ego Island.
At Ego. Not tell Nonya Joe. That's
fine. The Maputiti chief you got open. Now, well, hey, Nonya.
I may say that the operation was successful. And of course, the little community there is stronger now in its faith.
Yes, Nonya.
Will Hendrik be very much longer, do you think?
Would you like me to play for you, Nonya, with my guitar?
No, thank you. I'm not very musical, I'm afraid, in the primitive sense. I shall walk, I think. Nature is so natural, isn't it?
Yes, Nanya.
Thank you. open your mouth to me, you unregenerate punishment indeed. More like conspiracy. Come up! Come up! Come up! Living in pagan idleness instead of reforming yourself by responsibility and trust in as much backbone as you have conscience. Well, you've had your chance to reform and lost it, and you'll be deported if I have to go to the government over the head of the controller. Aren't you listening to me?
No.
Nunya, you want to sit down, please. It's getting very narrow here.
I can see that.
Toss me up there, Jed.
There'll be no drinking while I'm on board. Did you hear me?
Madam, they can hear you in Honolulu. Hurry. We'll put on the spare tire in the morning.
Morning?
Yes.
Well, we should have to wade ashore from the reef.
Does that mean we shall have to stay here all night?
We'll have to dam it for you.
I'm gonna take off my
Thank you.
Talk till you're blue in the face, but I don't believe
it. It was awful there.
You're a liar.
You ever lived 3 months on milk?
Wilson! Wilson! Oh, there you are. Dashing in so informally, how you do. When I heard that you were here, I simply had to come. Wilson, thank you, thank you. You've done a great and noble thing.
Here, now, now. Easy, man. That malaria is not out of your system yet.
Martha is right. There is so much good in the worst of us. I've misjudged you, and I beg your forgiveness from the bottom of a very full heart.
He is feverish.
I thought you were the worst of men, but you had my sister at your mercy. And you spared her. We see him in his true colors now at last, don't we, sir? God bless and guard you. Good night.
Oh, excuse me for dashing away so quickly, sir. My sister's not quite herself. Thank you again. Edward?
Didn't he call me Edward? What did the Jack in the Box mean?
He was thanking you because when you had her in your barrel at Island last night...
I did what?
You respected the virtue of Miss Jones.
Me? And her?
You and Master Jones. Well, well.
Yes, it's an insult. You can take it back.
Yes, it must be.
Must be one love. Yes? I better get drunk. I better stay drunk for a week.
But he doesn't answer our invitations, and Owen and I thought that if you could ask him to come and dine with us...
That's why you sent him. Well, I'm not further interested in that pilgrim progress, upward or down, if you'll excuse.
Yes, but if he could just once see what home life
is. I've not seen Wilson since your brother met him at my house. But I'll tell you right now, he'd fit into home life about as well as a bull in a...
You're prejudiced.
Yes, I dare say I am. But nevertheless, he's worthless.
No one is entirely worthless. And now, more than ever, we have an obligation to save him from himself.
I must be off now.
Oh, Mr. Grotty, you must have some tea. Owen will be back from the hospital soon, and I baked some of those crumpets we had last time you were here. Remember?
Yes, I do indeed. But if you'll excuse me.
Mr. Grotter, please, please help us. Help me. What can I do for that poor soul?
Well, from what I hear, all that he really needs is a bath.
I see it now. He refuses to come to us because he was ashamed.
Of what?
Of his appearance. He couldn't very well come to dine with us without some decent clothes.
Oh, that's the Englishman in him, of course.
Of course.
Well, I must now go to my office.
Is Edward Wilson his real name?
Good afternoon.
Mr. Grotter.
Look here. Miss Jones. He's just a rolling stone. And they gather no moss.
Edward Wilson will.
Thank you.
To. You meddlesome medic, get out of my house.
House? Brother thought you might not be offended if he lent you these clothes so that you could come and dine with us.
He did he? Well, I bet you put him up to it. Of the last thing you did to me, do you imagine I'd ever have anything to do with you?
Be quiet! You too! Did you step on something? Mr. Wilson, at times when friendship demands plain speaking. Oh. Brother and I count ourselves your friends. Oh. We consider that you need help, and help you will be, whether you like it or not. Now, let's have no more nonsense. Disinfect that thoroughly. Alcohol will do. You wash yourself and put on those things. And, Mr. Wilson, you have an even greater friend.
Don't you bring up that controller to me.
I was not speaking of the controller. I was speaking of God.
Dinner was at 7. I didn't want any, of course. But your stew all have gone nasty.
Oliver, I should like some strong tea, please.
Mark. Martha, dear, what is it?
I'll thank you to leave me alone.
Ma.
Owen, I'm sorry.
Mr. George. Oh, Miss George. I have something to tell your brother.
Mr. Grotta, I have something to say to you. You egged him on to drink by giving him all that money at once.
Wilson, the money was his. I had no right to it.
You had a moral right, and in the future, I want it exercised.
What, Martha? I apologize, dear.
So do I.
Look here, Jones. Aran has brought bad news. There's typhoid on Wanasombo Island. Of epidemic proportions, I'm afraid.
Oh, dear God. Owen, I'll pack for you.
Yes, take these. I'll get my kit ready.
If it spreads to the other islands. The enchanted isles of the eastern seas.
Smallpox, my first. Cholera, the next. Jones, you may have to be ruthless inoculating those natives.
I appreciated the difficulties when I chose my life's work.
I beg your pardon.
Better get clothes, Jones.
Put a these comfortable.
Yeah, maybe they'll fit the next dummy that stops up here.
Wilson, get out. You hear me? Get out.
I'm getting out all right in tomorrow's boat.
You know what?
I'm not going to be made a laughing stock of.
Now, look here, Wilson. Who's been making a laughing stock of you?
That sister of yours. She's got me developing a case of nerves.
At the moment, there is nothing of less importance than your nerves.
Well, what, sir?
Be quiet.
Typhoid on Wanasombo and extremely serious.
Oh, well, so long, Consul. I shall miss your company, but you can't have everything. And what I want now is peace.
Peace comes from within.
You put a sock in there. I was brought up on that stuff.
Yes. Mr. Jones has always tried to help you.
Oh, it is his duty, wasn't it?
We're a fellow man, a fellow Englishman in distress, no more. Now, we have a duty for you.
I serve my time.
You're one of us here, and you're needed.
Leap into an epidemic.
Yeah. Now, see here, Wilson. These natives are going to have to be forced to cooperate. I could do with a man there, you know.
Me?
Yes.
You're balmy.
No, he'd rather say sauce to the ear.
I don't think so. After all, you are a man. Aren't you? Well, what about it?
Thank you.
Hey, look out, hear that? All right, I've got it.
I'll go in my brother's place.
But you can't go alone.
Mr. Wilson is coming.
He can't go in the state he's in.
Yes, I can go.
Miss Jones is taking her brother's place.
Mr. Wilson, you're not drunk now?
No.
And you won't come?
With you? No.
After all, there's no reason why you should come. It is my job. I can go.
To meet us?
Yes, but I suppose he's busy with a fever in the village.
No, stop. I am not meet you. Stop. Nothing. Typhoid. He's speaking my dick. Typhoid. Down.
Scraping here.
My tummy.
Oh, but Hendrik, when I inoculated you against the typhoid, I told you that at first it might make you a little feverish.
Shall I?
You must go round, Doc. That is an ancient monument over graves. In the old belief, a man's soul is in his shadow. And if your shadow fall on graves, the dead come up alive. And we all...
Superstitious nonsense. Jolan.
I wouldn't mind if it wasn't for my feet.
Look, Mr. Wilson, there's the village down there. See?
Phew, bang in the middle of a swamp.
I believe I know how Miss Nightingale must have felt when she landed in the Crimea. Inspired. I shall begin the inoculations at once.
Here. Diam.
Stitch in time saves nine.
Diam!
It's unpleasant, I know, but so are most things. But if your own good, ready?
Begin Takut. Tungu Disana.
Dear Disana.
Saya Bichara.
Oh, here's Albert. Albert, tell your people to come back at once for their inoculations.
No, Nonya.
Yes, but this fever is.
Please, Nonya. The fever is your fault, they think.
Mine.
And mine. A punishment from heaven for deserting my father's gods for years.
Albert, you haven't reverted, have you?
Better you would go back now.
So that's what he was doing instead of meeting us.
Oh,
steady, Miss Nightingale. We'd better take a walk the other way. You must stop him.
I beg your pardon.
I left him alone for tonight. They're in a panic. There's half the village dying in its tracks. If they think their grandfather's idols are going to help him, you'd much better let him.
It's my duty
to... Our duty is to shoot this stuff in their arms.
Can't you understand?
Their religion is just as sacred to them as yours is to you.
It's idolatry! Tell them to remove that thing. Will you kindly do as I ask?
No! And neither will you.
Are you going to follow my orders, or are you not?
Yes, I'm not.
Indeed.
Take all that stuff off the table, everything else, put it in the dispensary.
How, Sick, Doyle.
Shot in the arm, same as you. Look at me, fresh as a daisy. This will fix you.
But Nonia Jones says I must never touch spirits, Doyle.
Hardening up sin, mate. There it is. Put your miseries to sleep. There's one gentleman in distress to another sergeant. I don't think I should mention the fact that I sneaked in this medicine to Mr. Hunt.
So you have to.
I must go my way and yours, I suppose.
That's you all over. To the dogs with just plain humanity, so long as you can ride to your own private upstairs in a first-class coach.
You've been drinking.
Honestly, only one.
Oh, Mr. Wilson.
Stop sniveling, and this time you stay inside till I say you can take the air.
Why?
Because you need to be taken care of.
You just did take care
of. For the sake of my own neck, not yours. Now you, hit the hay.
What?
It's an American expression. It means you go to bed.
It is expressive.
Yeah, good night. One more peep out of you, my girl, and I'll spank you. But you can't sit down. Half into the frying pan and she never turned her hair. You feel better?
Feel extraordinary.
Funny woman. Sergeant, you better sleep in the dispensary tonight. Dynamite around here might go off.
Thank goodness.
Mr. Wilson, you'll get wet through.
Oh, I'm used to it. Many a night on the beach, rolling stone like me, you know.
Oh, stop trolling. Do come in. Have a cup of tea.
Cup of tea?
Take your wet coat off, won't you? And sit down. It's just on the boil. I can't offer you milk, I'm afraid.
I never was much of a one for milk in my tea. It spoils the flavor of it. I mean, what's the point of tea if you can't taste the tea?
That's just how I feel. Oh, we mustn't catch cold, must we? Those towels. I should have thanked you for being so nasty to me tonight. You rather frightened me.
Did I?
Yes, you were so commanding.
Oh, your fault. Unbelievable. Miss Jones. Just thinking, it's rather swank sitting down and tea in this godforsaken spot.
Oh, it's not godforsaken here, Mr. Wilson. I know that now.
Would you mind if I smelt?
No.
When I come to think of it, you missionaries do a lot more good than you get credit for. I'll bet he's not such a bad fella when you get to know him.
Yes, that's true. I hope you like this.
You'll look fine.
This old thing. I meant tea.
Do you mind if I told you something, Miss Jones?
No.
I'd like to tell you the reason I had such
Nyonya
a chip.
Nyonya John? Wilson, Nyonya, help me in my childish sick. I'm so afraid.
Get her to me.
If the Nyonya was bad medicine an hour ago, isn't she now?
Maybe it is different for baby.
It's all right, we'll look after your kid.
Stop draining.
Yes, I know.
What is it, typhoid?
It may be. It's difficult to make the rose rush diagnosis on such dark skin.
What are you going to do?
Inject serum.
Mightn't that stuff?
Will you wash your hands, please?
Yes, please, she should, die after a shot of that. She's a headman's daughter. The acid killed her. It'd be sticky for us, you know.
Will you wash your hands, please?
Yes, ma'am. Ah.
Ah, it's all right, soldier. Of course it hurts. I had a tooth out once and yelled so hard, it rang the church bells a mile away.
She doesn't understand English.
Huh? Oh, it's never the words. It's the way you see them.
You have such a gift for language, Mr. Wilson. I wish I had.
Oh, I don't know so much about that. If you follow me, we both did pretty well in that court. Here, can I help you?
That was all the fault of the controller, egging you on.
Now, Mr. Greuther's lonely, that's all.
Who isn't?
Give me my child.
Ow.
Give me my child. Give me my child.
Look here, the nun is trying to make her well.
She will kill her.
Don't be an ass, Albert. She's a brave woman to try and save her. Knowing that if she did die now, those monkeys of yours would blame us and run wild. Hey, I could kill you and a few more with this pea shooter, and then watch you get us in the end.
Give me my child.
She's better off here. You get back to where you came from.
You have spoken to Tuan. You can shoot only a few of us, and then you are finished.
Like a lot of kids playing games. Did your brother ever march around the house walloping a drum? I did.
I'm sorry I got you into this.
Blast it, woman's place it in the home. I say, don't you start laughing at me now.
Oh, I never have, Mr. Wilson. I never thought you were a laughing stock.
I'd have been used to that. I was the fat boy at school. Used to call me Jack Spratt.
Jack Spratt could eat no fat. His wife could eat no lean. I didn't mean...
It's all right. They'd keep the platter clean. Anyway.
Think of expenses, I suppose.
Let me tell you, that argument that two can live as cheaply as one, so much twaddle.
I'm not prepared to admit that, Mr. Wilson. It's a question of household management.
Yes, with a manager getting all the salary.
Does that mean you've been married?
What? Me married?
What's the matter with it?
Everything.
How do you know if you've never been there?
You've only got to look at the papers.
Shh. There ought to be soon, one way or the other.
Where do you come from in England?
Kent.
I come from Bucks. I'd like to tell you something. I started to tell you once before this evening, Mr. Reed. It's the reason I carried such a chip on my shoulder about your preaching. Give me a hand. See, at home in England, I wanted to marry the local barmaid and become the landlord of the Fox and Rabbit Inn. Father and I had quite a scene. See,
My father was the vicar of Little Hazard. Bugs.
My father drank himself to death.
Hey, look, she's swearing! Albert! Albert! Your kid's gonna get better!
Oh, yes, they're both looking 10 years younger. What a big one. Yes, God moves in his mysterious way, his wonders to perform, and of course my sister is a very determined woman. I doubt whether after that night with her on the island, Edward ever had a chance. I suppose a woman scorned is a vessel of wrath. They're both sailing home for their honeymoon.
To England. 9,000 miles away.
Now, gentlemen, half time. Sorry, gentlemen. Act of Parliament.
Well, that's one for Fox and Rabbit.
Last drink with me, landlord?
Thank you, sir, no. Never touch it.
Righto.
Good night, sir. Good night, Mr. Taylor.
Good night, Mr. Robinson.
Good night, sir. Good night, madam. Good night, ladies. Good night, sir. Good night,
Mr. Wilson.
Good night, Sir John. Hope the ground's not too hard for housing.
Thank you. Good night.
Helen, I don't like my girls to be familiar with the customers. Josephine, hurry up with the glasses. We mustn't waste the electric light.
It was tiring, but a prosperous day. Mother, isn't that dress of yours cut a bit on the low side? It's all right, you know. That's no laughing matter.
You're tired, dear.
Good night, Helen. Good night, Josephine.
Good night, sir.
Oh, I'll so to bed.
Hip-a-hay.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.